Now, we shall discuss about the Coulomb law. In static electricity. Just now I said, like charges repel with each other, unlike charges attract with each other. The force between any two charges, depend on three factors: magnitude of the charges, second one, distance between the two charges, next, medium present between the two charges. What is the statement of Coulomb's law? The force of attraction or repulsion between any two charges is directly proportional to the product of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance separated by two, and takes place along the line joining between the two charges. Now we shall explain. Let us consider, this is one charge, Q1. Now let us consider there is another charge, Q2. What is the position? A is the position. What is the position? B is the position. What is the separation? Separation is represented by, let us consider R. Let us consider this is the positive charge, this is the positive charge. The charge Q will apply force on the charge Q2. The charge Q2 will apply force on the charge Q1. The charge Q1 will apply force like this, because this is go on repelling like this. This repulsive force, force on the second charge by the first charge. Again, Q2 charge go on repelling the first charge Q1. The force on first charge by the second charge Q2. Now, these two forces, F of 1, 2 is equal and opposite to F of 2, 1. F of 1, 2 is equal and opposite to F of 2, 1. Now let us consider this is represented by F. Now this force is directly proportional to product of the charges, that is Q1 and Q2. This force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance separated by two. What is the distance? R is the distance. What is the square of the distance? R square. And it is inversely proportional like this. Now, there is a relation directly proportional. Now, there is a relation inversely proportional. If the product value is increased, force value is increased. If the product value is decreased, force value is decreased. Now, what is the relation? Inversely proportional. If the distance between the two charges is increased, force is decreased. If the distance between the two charges is decreased, force is increased. That's why there is an inversely proportionality. Now, let us consider, this is called first equation. Now this is called, what to say, second equation, right? Now on combining both, F is directly proportional to Q1 into Q2 by r square. Right? Now f is equals to some constant. What to say? That constant is represented by k into q1 q2 by r square. Now this is called, what to say, Coulomb's law. Now this can be applied for any system. Suppose these two charges may be in air, these two charges may be other than in air. Right? Let us consider for SI system only, we are discussing about the SI system. If the two charges are placed in air, that is, the air is the media, what is the force formula? F is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q1 q2 by r square. Here in the air, what is the small k value? Small k value is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. The two charges are placed in air. The small k value is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. If this small k, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, is placed in this equation, this may be written as F is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q1 q2 by r square. Suppose, right, other than air, let us consider any medium.